Hello and welcome everybody to another soup. We are going to be doing part two, Silent King. I just loosely fit them together today, and we're just going to start putting in more block colors. So, yep, that's what we're doing. So let's sit back, relax, and enjoy the build. Get some music on. Just this camera. Alright, so yeah, good. Quickness is up. So let's get to it. So we're going to hit it up some more gold. Some folds. Awesome. Quite a bit gold. Just got pretty heavy. Hey, how's it going, Dr. Rhino? Oh, you missed it. Just as I started. I had a nice full view of my silent throne, at least. I will just tilt the camera. Check this out. Ooh, shaky cam. Ooh, what? Ooh. You're so lucky. Yeah, I'm not allowed to buy anymore. Any more minis? Yeah, I have. I got this metallic green actually to do the Silent King, and yeah. I need to finish this and start working on all my other Space Marines and oh. Yeah, that's really it. It's just like getting them to the prime state. That's kind of why I'm kind of happy that I'm doing the Silent King the way I'm doing it now, where it's gonna be probably like 4 or 5 streams of me just painting the Silent King. Ugh. Wait, is the recruit box the medium box or is it the small box? Because I remember buying the small box. If you're smart about it, it turns free. Because you could just sell off like Space Marines. Or wait, no, I think it was the other way around. I think it was the medium box came with the Outriders. And the Outriders you can sell, and it costs pretty much the same. Like, you end up making just as much. It made no sense. I have to get into all those cracks with gold. And I'm pretty much having gold veins running through the whole thing. Like some trippy fantasy. Like something out of, what's that? Guillermo del Toro's, like, mind. Where the gold is living. And also, like, Power Rangers. Yeah, I think it was better to buy the bigger box. Because if you sold off just the Outriders, it would come to the same price, but you get more Necron units. If I remember right. Because I think the only way for you to get Outriders is either to buy it in a set, or you get really, like, scammed, kinda. Because it's $70 Canadian for 3 Outriders. But if you buy, like, a $120 set, it comes with 3 things. It's kind of really messed up. Yeah, there was, like, a huge public service announcement on Reddit about that stuff. It was just like, yeah, this makes no sense, everybody. They're selling you, like, 10 Intercessors for $50. But you can literally... Oh, no, it was the Necron Warriors. Because I think they didn't have... they came with the options. And usually in start collecting stuff, you don't really get all the options. Ugh. Yeah, I'm nowhere close to done with any of my stuff. I just got like another batch of stuff. I gotta really kick it into high gear with painting. So many things to do. Which reminds me, aren't you doing that? You're doing your thingy. Your charity stream this month with the messed up size brushes, right? Where more donos equals bigger brush. Bigger donos, bigger brush. And at look pretty cool if they're not like the regular units. I saw a box of angels and stuff. Something called the Triumvirate of the Emperor. And it literally has the sister, the Inquisitor Greyfax, the three angel ladies, and one Admech guy. And the Admech guy looks insane. It just looks like a tank. Like, I can just imagine how, like, that would be Akira.
So pretty.
Wait, here's on the stone. What is up, Mr. Mexican? I just realized something, that I'm making this thing push. It's got gold. It's got green. It's freaking St. Patrick's Day colors. So, how's your brother? Doing good? That's as far as you know. He's just alive. That could be worse. Yeah, that's honestly a good part, right? It's that he's not, nothing's wrong with him. He's in good health. He doesn't have the Rona or anything. It's much what we can pretty much ask for at this point. I'm gonna get in some games soon. Hey, how's Cyberpunk treating you so far? I haven't even touched the game since like the last like 2 weeks. I haven't even been able to like open it up. I've been doing a lot of stuff. A lot of, like, learning. Jeez. Like, spoiler alert for everyone that, this may or may not be a spoiler. I'm on that mission where I have to invade a float because I have to talk to the dude's daughter. Like, I'm not even sure how far behind. Yeah, like, I'm really far behind. Well, not exactly far. But I just sat there and I grinded everything. I was just like, well, I don't
have this armor, so let me get stronger armor. And as I'm trying to, like, do all the side missions, I got sidetracked because, like, I wanted to finish the side quest, like, missions in one area. But some of them are, like, very high risk factor. So I'm like, damn. Lots and lots of gold. So has your mother roped you in for any other side projects? Any arts and crafts by mom? I'm just playing regular because I already know I don't have enough time for a lot of things. Like, I don't want to spend that much time in video game, especially one that is only replayable so many times. And there's only so many things I could do in that game. For me, it's a railroad game, right? Like, there's choice, but there's no real choice. I think, like, the last thing I tried to do was finish the Beat the Brat thing with the professional fighter in the ring, and he, like, annihilates my face. So I have to figure out a way to cheat-ish by, like, just dropping weapons and stuff. Because I just want to get it over with. Ooh, so much gold. Really? Like, I have the gorilla arms, but, like, it does almost nothing to him. And, like, he one-shots me. Yeah, I just gotta, like, play the game more. Alright, so that part's nice and cut out. Have to come in there and get all the green. And we'll be there. Yeah, I'm, like, really confused about the game at some point. It's just like, okay, you're allowed to do all this other stuff, but stuff in the game is supposed to be happening at this very moment. But somehow, I've gone off track and spent like 4 days just doing anything but the main story. Yeah, but like, I do stuff in the game. And then hacking just kind of got annoying, so it's just faster for me to literally just shoot everything. It's like, oh, these guys are doing a crime. Bam, 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 bam. Okay, everybody gets shotgun in the mouth. and then I go about my business. It's so sad. Because, like, everything's a headshot, and you can see people through things. So I'm just like, okay, I can also shoot through this thing and shoot these things in the skull. Okay. Done. So, Mr. Mexican, when are we gonna get around to learning how to play Warhammer? Gotta learn how to play soon. It's actually super fun. And my wifey is really enjoying the lore. She knows more lore than I do. It's kind of funny. Yeah, lots and lots of. Right. Let's break down the big old Silent King parts. It's not actually all, it's just pressure fit. Just cut any parts that didn't really get too well with the airbrush. Done. Thank you. What? Get a shovel? It's still snowing, isn't it? Should come back after and chat more. Guy calls people. It's just you're the one going to shovel snow. Lots. I'm going pretty ham on the gold, everybody. A little bit too much. Yeah. Hey, what's going on, Daiso? The silent witch dragon. Ooh, the dragon. So cute. Can't wait till everybody really starts getting the avatars that they want, and then the battle royales start with just a bunch of people. Then I can semi-practice being a commentator. So many layers of this to make it all even. Right. Right. Yeah. Lots and lots of gold. So how are you? What are you up to? No problem. What's going on, Jared? Watching me block out massive parts. And for those who haven't seen it, moving the camera. That's the throne. I'm happy that everybody decided to show up. What's going on, Splendor Brush Tribute? Oh, it's a big boy. And what's cool is that because I properly put it together, most of the pieces just kind of hold it together with no glue. It's just like, ugh. Oh, yeah. Basing. I don't know how. Is basing fun for you? Because for me, it seems kind of chore-ish. I'm just like, oh, I don't know. Do I enjoy basing my stuff? I do enjoy basing, but on. It seems kind of, I'm doing stuff. I think it's because I have to get my 3D printer back up and running and print out, like, other little things. Ugh. I literally just take the base with the mini on it at this point. I have, like, a tub of sand and grit and everything. Just super glue the whole thing. And then just dunk it in there, shake it around, and then pull it out and, like, scrape off anything off the edge with my fingers. And I'm just like, eh. I gotta rip off another piece off this thing. Let's do some more gold. Oh, okay. Yeah, I'm always worried about, like, pinning it, because I don't know if I'm gonna get, like, the right, like, angle back, or it might, like, be floating on top of the stuff, because my terrain won't be flat, and then I'll be kind of sad. So, this part doesn't need to be there. I should have to put gold on the inside of those. Gotta pop off. Actually, I gotta pop off this thing. See, pops right off. Just gotta disassemble this thing so I can reassemble everything. This thing is the thing that was gonna hold. Okay. Do that. I'm gonna do some fun stuff. Alright, re-angle this camp. And we can get to some more. How do you host? I'm not actually sure. Frosty knows how to do it really well. Same thing with Dice Dome. It's like a weird thing. I have people host it on an auto host thing, but I'm not sure if it ever works. And it just confuses me. There you go. Dice Dome knows what's up. Alright, let's see. Let me just have a quick look at this piece. Honestly, I've never done it. I just made people. I think it has to be in your personal chat. Like on your chat, if anything. I think I'm gonna have to come back and spray that. Oh well. So we're gonna hit this banister thing with some gold. So why not? Seems fun. Painting banisters. Little fin things. go. This. So what's everybody working on? If y'all are working on stuff. I know some people are physically at work. Don't get caught. Stone guard. That's the ticket. Just get in some gluing. Are you using the fast drying cement? Reminds me, I have to call the post office tomorrow. Because I'm supposed to have a package coming. But it's been late for a few days. So now I actually have to call and be like, hey, you know, you guys, where the heck's my package? Seems like you guys have lost it because it reached Montreal on Tuesday. It's now Thursday and it has not moved. And claiming that it's like, oh, we still have overflow from like Christmas, it's like, okay, it's been a month. Like, people stopped sending presents a while ago. All the coins. No problem. Softly touch the emerald. Don't have to worry too much about hitting underlay parts because that will not hit to wash. Save time here. It's a little blotchy. Hope I get another boat. Not a lot of the gold today. And then the wash as well. Enrich. Capacity depth. Get a little bit of texture. Side and it's fun. Wait. We have the other side.
All that dry brush them in. Brush them in. Let's see who survives the battle royale today. Oh, the rigness. The rigness. Sent everybody back. Thank you.
No. Yeah, I'm trying it out. Hey, how's it going, F5? Oh, the majestic pinbot. Yeah, I wasn't shooting through my airbrush that nice. And then on top of that, it seems like it comes out more even. Like, I brushed on this side, and it took forever. But yeah, it seems like it would come out a little bit. It's about the same, really. Well, I airbrushed, like, the whole thing, like, the metallic green. The gold was just acting up. The, lead belcher? It came out super nice. I think lead belcher was the one that, like, shot the easiest through my airbrush. And, like, it was the exact color that I shot out, too. It wasn't, like, off by a bit, and then I had to come in and touch it up. And multiple passes. It's just so... It actually shot out the easiest. I just put some thinner, and it's already been thinned down with a little bit of water. I just jammed it in the airbrush and shot it. Came out really, really nice. And you missed it, Pinbot. I had the entire throne put together. And I was just panning my camera up so that people could see like the whole thing put together. It was really pretty. You miss all the fun stuff. So how's it going, F5? How are you today? Happy that you can come join the monumental undertaking that is the Silent King. Well, currently it's just the Silent King's throne. But nonetheless, we're getting there. We're getting there. This one I'm stippling. But what I do know is that I am really going through a bunch of pain. Especially the gold. Lots and lots of gold. Fix that after. Mm-hmm.
actually. But do we want to change this? Well, that's hilarious. It's fun. A different tricks. Yeah, now we're also gonna go with just a touch of just fix up the boo-boos that I made. God, didn't I? So nice to brush on them. Thing here. Whoop. I know I did on these boys. Look at that. Look at that overspray. Dance. So how are your Necrons and Space Marines coming along, Spinbot? Coming along good? As long as you get... I have so many bottles I've got a huge queue up for. I can't wait to get it all done. Oh, did you start on the Scorpic Lord? Yeah, you'll get color fatigue, like, building an army. Like, I got really color fatigued when I was doing the Necrons. Because it was just literally the same 3-4 colors, so it was just like, And it wasn't even like I was completing stuff, but it was just like, the feeling of, am I really completing anything, took over, and that kind of sucked. Just like, okay, I finished one, but there's like 6 more of the same exact dude. Ugh, Necron Warriors. And what's worse is that I made them all with one type of weapon. So, my next batch, I have to do with all the other type of weapon. And I'm not even sure if I will do that. The overspray because it's not super heavy.
instant erase. Not so bad, especially if it's just if you base coat and at least like highlight everything, should be right. Overspray. It's really quick. Depends, like, let's say your dreadnought and your vehicles, you can do those really quickly. Especially with an airbrush, you're just like, you'll spray through everything. You base coat everything. Depends also, like, how much paint of whichever color. You could base coat everything white. Base coat everything black. Highlight all the center of the panels white. And just go very, very lightly over everything with red. And then what will slowly happen is that, like, the darker areas will still always be dark. And it's just like, you know, in the grooves of stuff. And then anything that's white will be bright and pretty. So you're just pre-shading everything before you spray it. And then what you have to do is, like, you have to seal it if you're going to be using it as a game piece. Because you're always going to be handling it. If it's just like a showpiece, you just leave it as is. Graffiti. I actually really like this brush. Like the monster brush. It feels kind of like it's got a nice point for the most part, except for that weird little straggly bit. Got a large enough body. It's got a nice holds moisture. I can get my job done. Yeah, it works really nice. Yeah, actually, it's funny because this is one of like the cheaper like army painter ones. Like, I have this one that I was using for the longest time, but like the handle exploded because when I was cleaning it, I left a little bit of water on it and it just exploded the casing. And I was like, okay. Because it, like, the water, like, got right up into there, and just I used this for 2-3 weeks straight without having it dry properly. So sad. But yeah. Like, this is definitely not a detail brush. Can certainly serve quite a lot of stuff. Here's one. Yep.
Step. Can I do? Cool.
surprisingly, it's pretty. Like, the tip's pretty good. And, like, it's a big old brush, too. Much kind of like it. Like, I can load up quite a bit of paint. Don't have to be super duper worried about it, like, drying out. Get quite a bit of work done with it. Clean up. So pretty. Next. Lift it up, suck that lead belcher to clean up the rear thrusters that I did today. So I take yeah, like my lead belcher is super. When I transferred it over, I put a little bit too much water. But it works out. It's like I've pre-thinned my paints. Then sometimes it just doesn't flop with it. Whoops. Yeah, that's when, you know, your paint's a little bit too... pours out. Massive amounts of overspray. Yeah, I think it was just because I was trying to get the paint to be ultra accurate. Because I noticed when I did these back ends and I shot it from like super far away, it came up really nice, but the moment you got up close, it's just impossible. Because you have to spray like a ridiculous amount of this stuff, and it shoots out super nice. That's that rear thruster. Chat, I need a show to watch. I need a show to watch while I'm building stuff. Watched just about everything on Amazon Prime. Just about everything on Netflix. And I need new suggestions. And for anybody that's watching on YouTube, please leave a comment in the comment section. I want to know. Kind of looks like what I'm doing, because there's OSL on the sheet. It's like on the plates here. Into the Badlands. Is that the one with like the ninjas and stuff? I forgot what it was, but there was one. I think it was on Netflix too. All right, it kind of got slow at one point, and I was just like, "Nah, what's PC? I can't. What is going on today?" Let's check this. 15 YouTube things running. I wish I could follow hockey. Hockey is one of those things where it's just like, eh, I kind of like it, but it's just not my bag. It always throws me for a loop. I can't really follow it. Like, I can understand, like, American football, just because, like, it starts and stops. And it's like a sport that you can watch while, like, drinking. Because I can't understand, like, going to a bar to watch hockey when you are solely focused on the match. It's like, blink once, oh, you missed the goal. Oh, okay, well, too bad. So sad. But, like, football, it's like, they run a play. You hear it, and then they're like, oh, here it goes, and then stuff happens. So then you're there, and you get all the expectation of it all. So, that's how I get at it. Crazy origin might be puzzles as true as fiction is. Oh, no. And that probably just solves all my blank check issues, because Epic Games
and Origin like to work together to be. Though Epic Games does like to be weird and at least offer me free games. Oh, yes. I'm gonna try to fill in the back end. This. Flexing on people with that crazy big old. Just remember, we want to be ultra precise right here. Because the wash is going to come in, and what the heck is going on with my stream? Keep you in mind. PC is lagging out. See how this looks. Yeah, put this there. Need gaming on YouTube? Who am I might need gaming on YouTube? Like Twitch style gaming? Or like TV gaming? Because that's the thing, right? You don't like what kind of gaming are we talking about? Think about sports, talk about like video game streams. Well, look at that. Every time. Oh, where's Frosty? I did not do the inside yet. I'll put it on anyway. Just because. Look at this. So what's kind of funny is that there's no real way to get that without like actual football. So that's gonna be kind of a pain. So I'll have to hold that together and glue it. What stays in place. Look at that. Pretty, pretty, pretty. Oh, that's how it sits. Check this out.
And then you have all these little dangly bits right here. Yeah. Then you got the crazy big guy that's right up in the middle. And he floats up there and it's all encapsulated in gold in the water. That's fun. Like, I'm not even done with, like, anything. I'm just base coding most things. So, yeah. And then I have to figure out why the golems are being naughty and not... And it's just, like, not cooperating. Yeah. And it's fun, because everything kind of just assembles and disassembles. Yet. Ooh. It's always scary when I try to pop it apart. Like, I have the fear built in. It's like, if it snaps, I'm gonna cry. Oh, yeah, I forgot. I didn't remember that Star Wars Battlefront, the one that Epic Games gave out for free, has a single player. Really get on playing. Seems fun. And I know that Star Wars Legion. Number 5 alive. I'm not sure what that's from. Yeah, you do. I'm pretty sure like half of those are also bots. Like, just like accounts created just to claim that game. And a lot of, like, other countries, you could claim it, and you just use it at an internet cafe, and you hope that it drives business up, because certain parts of the world, internet cafes are still a thing. So it's like, let's say you had, like, 100 PCs, well, you just get 100 free copies of stuff. No, I think it was... You'd have to check how it's worded, whether it's active players or just new players. If it says like 19 million active players, that's a different story, but I highly doubt it's active players. Stain. Foam for the rinse bottle. I feel like I'm just like I'm bringing it upon myself by painting everything over my wet palette. It's like I'm asking for it.
Come watch ShirohSenpai tempt fate, painting over his wet palette at all times. Dun dun dun. When will he drop it next?
Whoa, that's quite a bit. What'd you trade in? I don't know how I feel about layers. I don't know how I feel about layers. Miniature. It looks weird. Like, she doesn't look like Leia. Oh no, I would have told you, you should always keep your lands. The Elspeth, yeah. Might as well, just because it's Elspeth, comes and goes, but lands, like, those are always, they have, like, cycles of how much stuff is worth, especially now, because they can't reprint older dual lands. So, there's always, like, a cycle. Yeah, magic is, I don't know, it's in that spot again. Where nobody wants to play it, but it seems like it's in that downturn, but in a couple of years it's gonna come back. And then all the stuff that we're gone for from now till then is gonna be worth a lot. Like, I'm going to look for the new Lotus for Commander. I'm gonna sell a couple of, like, the, like, extra lands that I have that are, like, over my playsets that I've, like, kept for, specifically for trading. I've, like, looked around. But it seems like it's a hard to get. But a Lotus is a Lotus.
Nice.
I most likely will end up doing something very remotely along that line. Like, I just need to figure out why there's so many online only retailers when normally, you are required to have a brick and mortar. Well, it's because freaking game avatars is all low. Might be. Kind of sit there rendering frames. Just me. Where are those two other thrusters? Alright, here we go. They're gonna have to pull them off like cherries. It's done. What's going on, Walter? Not much. We are doing some fun blocking of the Silent King and fixing up a bunch of overspray. Because I spray it. But besides that, everything's good. What about you? What are you working on today? Prepping some stuff for your stream? Yeah, that's right. You got your new gig. Forgot about that. Then we can easily get it to you. You got yourself a nice gig. I'm just over here applying for positions, like crazy fun jobs. I tried applying for a model maker job at Mattel, it just seemed interesting. I asked one of my friends that currently works there. I was like, what's this job actually entail? It's like, oh, you put together those giant diorama things and you make them roadworthy for shows. I was like, oh my god, that's literally what I used to do, but instead of for shows, it was for large-scale water filters at my first welding job. It was pretty awesome. So I was like, well, you know, like, might as well apply. See if, like, if I get that job, one, I'll be surprised. Two, I will bust my ass. Because that just seems like a super cool job. Like, not for the fact that, one, you're playing with toys. But it's just the fact that it's just like, imagine what I built inspires a kid to do something amazing. You know, like when you hear those kids, like just like in the future, they're like, hey, you know, so what inspired you to like do whatever it is that you wanted to become that changed the world? It's like, oh, so I went to this like convention one time with my parents and I saw this crazy looking diorama display thing that, you know, that somebody built. And I thought, wow, what a great thing, you know? And then I'll be like old and I'll hear that on the news. And I'll be like, hey, what were you like, what show were you talking about? It's like, are you talking about this thing? Because I built that thing. What's up? But yeah, like, I don't know. She did, however, tell me that it's like, yeah, there's a lot of people with, like, art degrees. But I'm like, yeah, but, like, what does an art degree have to, like, do with anything for that job? Really, you're making something that somebody else has told you, like, this needs to be built. Like, they give you blueprint, and then they kind of give you somewhat free reign, I guess. It's like, it has to weigh this much, make it be able to be packed into a truck, like a moving truck, and, like, make it roll on wheels, is generally what most people ask for. So for me, I'm like, oh, we've done all that stuff. It's like rolling cases, build boxes. Building boxes is nothing to laugh at. Because you got to make a box pretty quick, pretty solid, and yeah, it's quick. Yeah, but that's the thing. I was just like, how does an art degree have any, like, I can understand for, maybe she, I think I also read it wrong. She might have just said, like, oh, you meant generally, like, the jobs that she knows about has, like, something to do with an art or engineering degree. But model making, it's just, like, can you do this really fast? Because generally, like, you have the most time when you're, it's up in the beginning, right? And then as it trickles down, you have less and less time because it's coming closer and closer to the deadline. And then we're, the model makers are the ones that are like, usually the ones that are told like, hey, you know, sorry to spring this on you, but could you get this built in like half the time? And like get it ready to get shipped out. But it was so cool. She showed me like a display thing of like the evolutions of Squirtle. It's super awesome. It's made out of like Mega Blocks. I was like, oh my god, so awesome. Like, I don't mind like putting blocks together, but I'd love to be building stuff. Like building the innards of like the models. That seems super fun. Oh, yeah. Block off all of that. Yeah, Walter. I think I found my new one of my new favorite brushes, the Wargame Monster. Nice pointy tip. Holds a lot of like water. Lets me work without going back and forth, back and forth. Okay, so now we're gonna hit up the goal. Hopefully it's not all messed up again. Just plug my phone in. Phone went off. Give me just a second, everybody. I think. Make sure I have to get this call. Well, here's just for a size person. This, and then you have the master class. They both end up at the same relative tips. Just a second. Be right back, everybody.